it's a pleasure to welcome the Chief Commercial Officer of Hedge Project, HDG, to the show on his debut. Giovanni Lesna, a financial product specialist, Peter Spinas, top pick, the Hedge Project. They have a unique platform that helps enable everyone to participate in the crypto markets in an efficient and accessible way. Welcome, Giovanni.
Thank you for having us on the radio. We really do appreciate it.
Giovanni, your proprietary crypto indices look as though they will transform the way investors increase exposure to these interesting new markets. It also includes the possibility of short selling.
I think we're delivering a very unique value proposition, you know, towards the crypto community. I'm sure everybody can see that, you know, Bitcoin in the last week rallied from $8,200 to just under $11,000 currently. What we've done is, you know, in terms of the risk, having all your eggs in one basket is quite risky. So what we've, you know, our product offering is a diversified index, which will allow investors a risk-diversified, cost-effective way to actually invest in cryptos and obviously get that risk-adjusted return over the long term. So that is what we've set out to do. And we do see that the crypto market is maturing for that, as you can see with the Bitcoin futures being launched on the CME later this year and also on NASDAQ in 2018. A lot of institutional capital will start flowing into the crypto space. So I think we're well positioned to take advantage of that with this unique product offering.
If we look at your proprietary crypto indices, one of the more, I think, intriguing aspects is the Bookman Index. This apparently is a 30-component basket, according to your literature, of the cryptocurrencies. Now, it has really, frankly, all of our favorite top currencies, such as obviously Bitcoin at around 20%, Ethereum at 20%, which we think could be a five-bagger next year, Bitcoin Cash, which, as you know, Roger Ver is really big on, and so is his whole community there. Litecoin, which we think is underloved here. It really, in terms of Bitcoin, has not advanced at all. A huge opportunity. And that comes in at around 5%. Of course, I didn't mention Bitcoin Cash around 14%. Tell us the significance and any other interesting details regarding your hedge components.
What we've done is we followed the professionally designed rulebook-based approach. So similar to your S&P 500, where traditional investors would say with, you know, crypto indices that follow a rulebook-based approach. And what that does is it allows us to be objective in the way that the index functions. So as you mentioned, it is a basket of 30 cryptocurrencies, and our crypto 30 actually ends up tracking 90% of the market capitalization of the crypto coin market. So currently it's sitting at about $353 billion, and 90% of that value is coming from your crypto top 30. So essentially, you are buying the market when you invest in this type of instrument. What is quite notable about the crypto top 30 is it is rebalanced in real time. So we draw inputs across 7 crypto exchanges so that you don't get that disconnect in data and you always remain relevant up to date. It is reconstituted monthly. So in other words, the components of the index are changed monthly. Because of that professionally designed rule book, there are specific rules that a specific crypto needs to follow to remain in the crypto top 30. So as an example, liquidity measures in order for it to form part of the crypto 30. So as an example, you'll see that BitConnect is missing from the constituent. It doesn't meet the liquidity requirement in terms of the trading pairs, and that's why it's missing from the index. So this is a passive index. What that means is we don't actually pick the constituent. It works on the market capitalization of the crypto market. So that, in essence, is what the rulebook does. And you can actually find that on our website. We have it all transparently displayed on the website, which is www.hedge-crypto.com. There we have the fact sheets, which show you the constituents of this crypto 30, as well as the rulebook, which stipulates all the, you know, methodology of the functioning of that index.
Two thoughts come to mind. Firstly, with regard to the component that you've excluded from the basket, hat tip for that, I'd like to really extend to our listeners today the importance, maybe even underscore, highlight, and embolden the importance of being super cautious, red flags on top of one another. The second thought that comes to mind, Bitcoin Cash, why is portfolio diversification so important? Well, take a look at Bitcoin. As you mentioned, we've just had an enormous breakout. We actually called it last week on the show. We were looking for about 11,000. We exceeded those expectations, close to 11,005. However, However, this trend might have ebbs along the way. There could be peaks and valleys. The nice thing about your Bitcoin Cash component, considerably lower beta, which helps balance your Bitcoin and Ethereum exposure. The Buckman Index, which we talked about, has several interesting sectors, including value transfer, gaming and gambling, media and social anonymity, platform and asset peg, as well as other decentralized and you might even say disruptive components. Please tell us the significance of this diversification strategy.
As I mentioned, it is a passive index. So what that means is, depending on which of the top 30 make it into to that requirement, it just happens to be that the sectors have been broken up in this way. So you can see that a lot of the composition of the basket is coming from your value transfer. So what that is it's based essentially your current such as your Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash. No, that's right. The crypto sectors are not selected. So this is completely passive. So what happens is, depending on the market capitalization of the specific crypto that makes it into the crypto 30 based on the rule book based objectives, that will then include it into the index. And it so happens to be that the crypto top 30 is constituted mainly from your anonymity as well as your value transfer and platform-based cryptocurrencies. I think that's also an indication of, where, initial coin offerings and the crypto space is heading towards. So you can actually see the breakdown of that. So we just did that so that people can understand which crypto coins form part of which sector. And that's the unique offering of this Buckman Index.
This domain is really in early days, if you will. It's almost the Wild West. And clearly, you've already addressed a bit the derivative situation and how the CME Bitcoin futures contracts are expected or anticipated within the next few weeks, possibly before the end of 2018, but it's looking like that might be delayed. Another interesting opportunity for HDG, for Hedge here. Obviously, you have a unique crypto derivatives contract or contracts, futures and options and instruments. You know, there's not too many ways to make this play right now. Right now we have BitMEX, BITMEX. That's one of the few futures markets. Give us an idea of how HDG plans to open up this exciting area.
In addition to index and the overlying crypto traded indices that we intend to offer, which is a crypto to crypto investment that you can jump into. So in other words, you're going to create a unique value proposition for hedge token holders as well as for the hedge platform. We are going to be tackling that in two parts. One would be the crypto traded indices, which we're going to offer on our platform, as well as what you were mentioning, the derivative instruments that would be linked to crypto. It's actually quite an interesting space that we're in at the moment. We can see that the Scandinavians are quite on the ball with derivative instruments such as your exchange-traded notes. And, a couple of weeks back, we saw Jamie Dimon, JP Morgan, as well as Morgan Stanley being the biggest buyers of Bitcoin exchange-traded notes on that NASDAQ Swedish exchange. And also, with the news coming out now from the CME, as well as the Chicago Mercantile Exchange, as well as NASDAQ announcing in 2018 that they also want to bring Bitcoin futures into the market. This is going to bring a lot of institutional money into crypto, and essentially this will allow Bitcoin to find its true value. Yet we are uniquely placed to take advantage of that once that is in the mainstream. The hedge platform will help facilitate that. So as we mentioned, Q1, Q2 of 2018, on our platform, we are going to do crypto-to-crypto crypto-traded indices that you'll be able to track the basket of 30, the crypto top 30. And eventually, we look to also take fiat, so you'll be able to invest using USD or Euro into your crypto-traded indices. That's a little bit later on down the line. But in addition to that, we will also offer crypto-derivative instruments, whereby you'll be able to use to manage your positions and take positions in the market.
Just last week when we first spoke on the phone, the market cap for cryptos was approximately 250. At last check, we had eclipsed $300+ billion. This is forecast by many to be just the opening bell, if you will, for the entire sector. Why don't you give an idea or let folks know any other additional aspects about this exciting opportunity in hedge?
So we're also going to be, by the end of Q4 2017 releasing additional indices. You know, if you don't want to buy 90% of the crypto market, which we also see that we need a benchmark to compare your crypto investments to. You cannot compare your Bitcoin return, the return you make on your equities portfolio. So we hope that the Buchmann Crypto 30 will become the new benchmark used gauge the return that you make on your crypto portfolio, or alternatively investing in an initial coin offering. So if you're not making, the minimum of the return of 90% of the crypto market, then you're obviously underperforming. But we're also going to be releasing additional crypto indices in addition to Buchmann Crypto 30. And you know, the exciting news, Chris, is we've actually successfully integrated with Thomson Reuters. So for traders out there that I'm sure there's thousands of traders using the Thomson Reuters Icon trading platform, you'll actually have direct access using the ticker BCC30. You can actually track top 30 cryptocurrencies by market capitalization in real time. So we have successfully integrated with them as well as Morningstar. In addition to the Buchmann Crypto 30, we'll also be releasing additional crypto indices that have specific rule books. So we're looking at Crypto 30 Equal Weight, a Crypto 30 Uncapped, Crypto 10, a crypto risk parity, as well as a crypto five, so top five. So you will have various sectors that you can actually invest in to suit your specific investor, and this is where we see the opportunity, because we know not everybody would want to invest in 90% of the crypto market. We do have other people that would like to rather invest in, like, let's say, your dark coins, your Moneros, your Dash, and we will have a specific crypto index that will track, just say, the dark coin index. So you can actually then end up trading that crypto traded index once we have it on our platform, and you can just completely focus on those dark coins as a basket to invest in.
Two thoughts come to mind here. Firstly, I'd like to point out, just how the Bitcoin ETF has skyrocketed now, certainly more than tenfold since its introduction just 1 year ago. And really what the hedge folks here are doing today, bringing forward a basket that includes Bitcoin, but really all of the interesting diversification within the sector. There is no other opportunity that we can find like this. That's the first point I'd like to make. So think of the potential opportunity as this market space goes from a measly $300 billion, not even one component on the Dow Jones, to obviously a multi-trillion-dollar space, we think rivaling even the Forex in the next few years. This really presents an opportunity for everyone to get that diversification without the risk of an ICO. The ICO has come and passed. We all have to do our own due diligence. I cannot promote anything, and I'm not a registered financial advisor, so I can't give investment advice. But let's take a look at where the hedge token is as far as a value opportunity. Right now, it's trading around 1/5 of that level. Well, if you're a believer in the story and you want some exposure, you've got an 80% discount opportunity from the ICO. Again, no promises, but it's just, I think, an important thing for the investor to consider while doing their due diligence.
We have seen a parabolic rally. I was actually watching Squawk Box on CNBC earlier today, and just seeing those anchors so passionate about this parabolic rise, obviously just advising caution to everybody, especially over that steep decline. As we mentioned, we were just chatting last week at $8,200, and it's been pushed over that to $11,200 or $11,300. So definitely advise caution to that. Usually when things increase so rapidly, we do have a bit of profit taking. So I would not expect anything less than some profit taking and a little bit of a correction. But I do think in the longer term, Bitcoin should rise based on the fact that I think only 0.1% of the global population actually know what a Bitcoin is or have access to it. And I think that's where Hedge has a unique value proposition. We essentially want to bring mom and pop to crypto, as well as allowing your average investor to your institutional investor to have access to a risk-diversified, risk-adjusted portfolio of the crypto top 30 and additional indices that are available on the Hedge platform. So we find that that will add a unique value proposition. And instead, you know, there's thousands, I'm sure, Chris, you can see this, you know, due to the ICOs, there's been thousands of new quizzes, I think 1,300, 1,400 tokens in total. How did you go about selecting the right winner? The way I see it, just as Vanguard was successful, you know, you buy the market, you hold the market, and you get that long-term wealth, because eventually, you know, you can't beat the market consistently over time. So by having a diversified portfolio, essentially, of 90% of the crypto market, you can achieve, you know, long-term growth and wealth, and you don't have to waste time day trading. You don't have to waste time on costs. You don't have to waste time now opening up multiple wallets or multiple exchanges, because in the crypto space, you can't actually access every single token in one place. And that's what Hedge is: buy the crypto market with one click. It's that simple.
I have a slightly different take on what's occurring here. I'm a seasoned investor, so you might say I've been through the cycles of these markets and the precious metals and U.S. shares. I believe this time, and this is a frightening thing I'm going to say, things might be a little different. And I say that with a touch of humor. The real story here behind Bitcoin, it's not just the limited supply of around 16 million currently, 7 trillion people in the world, but I think the real story might be the end of the reserve currency. It appears as though we could be entering a Weimar-style runaway price situation as the currency is exposed as flawed, and we find this one market close to being as free as a free market can be, simply because the hash rate, the strongest, you might say, supercomputer in the world, many, many fold over this, the hashing power, if you will, uncontrolled market has been set free. I'm sticking with my Weimar scenario, calling for 15 to even 40,000 Bitcoin in the next few months. I think we'll see 100 to 150,000 by the end of 2018. On Bitcoin, unless there is some coordinated effort by all the world's central banks and governments. I even question, though, because I might point out that some of the smartest minds have said, if China could not contain Bitcoin, it will not be contained, period. But I hope folks will keep in mind that these are early days. Anything else you'd like to share with us today, Giovanni Lesna?
So, Chris, we're actually going to be doing in 2018, a roadshow. We're going to try and be on each continent. We are going to also be at the Crypto Space Moscow conference on the 8th of December 2017. So you can come in and have a chat with us there if anybody's in the area, speaking about how to optimally diversify your crypto risk to achieve the best Sharpe ratio. So we'll be there speaking at the conference. And we also have a lot of exciting news lined up in our roadmap. So as I mentioned earlier, Q4 this year, we're going to release additional indices, and Q1, Q2 next year, the platform will go live, as well as the crypto traded indices. Even more exciting, obviously, given the developments in the space regarding, you know, your Bitcoin futures, we hope to then by the end of Q4 2018 or Q1 2019, you know, create an ETF, an exchange traded fund that will be tracking the index that we've created as an overlying instrument. And essentially bring that to the public in a regulated KYC compliant manner, and you know, allow anyone to invest in crypto essentially through a stock exchange. So we can see that the space is going in that direction, and as I mentioned, I think we're uniquely positioned to leverage that and to get into that.
All right, Giovanni Lesna, we can't wait to have you back on GoldSeek to keep us updated. You know, return with all the topicality as this exciting story progresses, as the new instruments and indices, obviously increasing their exposure and jumping through the regulatory hurdles, and maybe even just as excitingly, as the institutional interest and hedge fund interest grows for this platform. Because can you imagine the pent-up demand as the typical money manager recognizes, wait a minute, U.S. equities? Really? That's the only exciting market out there? Let's look at Bitcoin, you know, a 10Xer in just less than a year or so. Frankly, we're looking for perhaps as high as a 5X on Ethereum next year. Litecoin, we think, is underloved. Another potential 5 to 10X. No guarantees, but exciting stuff.
You You know, I'd also just advise that you wouldn't want to be looking back 10 years from now and see what you've missed out on. So obviously, as a prudent investor, you wouldn't be going take out a mortgage to Bitcoin. Some of these stories I've been hearing about. You definitely want to at least put maybe 5 to 10% of your portfolio to get that additional exposure so that you don't actually miss out on the bull run in the sector. So I think it would be something interesting to pursue, and as you mentioned, definitely to all investors need to do their due diligence and not just believe what they see, but also obviously do that research and see that, that that's where it's going. You can also follow us on Twitter. We at Hedge Tokens. You can also join our Telegram group. Chris, the last thing is we have such an engaged community talking about various cryptos, talking about alternative investments within the group. So it would be great for you, for investors and listeners to actually join our Telegram, post it on our progress, as well as to be there for the announcements that we make and the roadshows that we're going to. We're also on Facebook, we're on LinkedIn. So we're basically on all your social media channels. You know, if there's any media that wants to, discuss the concept of a crypto-traded index further, any type of investor that has any specific questions, I don't mind them reaching out directly to me and we can have a nice conversation on that. So I'll just give out my email address. It is Giovanni, so G-I-O-V-A-N-N-I, at hedge-crypto.com. And we can take it from there. But thank you, Chris. Thank you for having us on the radio. Hopefully we can, and I'm sure, Ethereum, as they say, a rising tide lifts all ships. If Bitcoin obviously rallies, then it will pull the rest of the market with it. So I definitely think $1,000 Ethereum does not seem unrealistic to me.
No, exactly. And we're calling for much, much higher than that. But we have to look at this as what percentage of folks are really aware. You touched on that. Maybe 1% worldwide, 1% in the US, 1% in Asia, 1% in Europe. Yes, I agree with you. Let's not take out second mortgages. Let's not max out the credit cards. At the same time, I think you bring a great point forward, and that is FOMO. Fear of missing out. Well, maybe that's a legitimate concern on, the sector as a whole, as a component of your overall portfolio. Seems like prudent thinking on a forward basis. And we want for everybody to increase their exposure in a dollar cost averaging format where you really can't lose. If Bitcoin were to drop, let's say to 7,900, we see strong support. If you're dollar cost averaging, that's far less painful and rather a profitable endeavor, as we think it goes many, many fold from these levels.
You know, I've already switched over from my Bitcoin profits into Ethereum and other smaller altcoins for the reason being that, as I mentioned, a rising tide lifts all boats or all ships. And, it becomes unattainable. Who has $11,000 to buy one?
Isn't that really the genius of Satoshi Nakamoto? The divisibility, right, down to more than one millionth, one Satoshi. Really, if you think of it, there's never been a financial instrument with this remarkable characteristic. We used to be able to have 1/8 of a doubloon, if you will, the system based on a fractional. Then we went the decimalization. So we'll look at Venezuela, for instance, and tens of thousands of people are mining their own Bitcoin as their only means of survival. In Zimbabwe, but it's not just isolated to those two areas. Frankly, we see frightening Venezuelan style and Weimar styling issues plaguing perhaps the whole country.
If you have any questions, just on a personal basis, feel free to shout. I thought I was doing a bit of trading myself on the crypto space, and we're pretty much up to date. But you're right, I think the time of the ICO is a little bit over at the moment, and a lot of scams coming about. It's quick, quick money. I think investors are a little bit cleverer than that these days. So yeah, I think it's going to be a very interesting space. And
be careful when you're diversifying into Ethereum, Litecoin, Monero, Dash, and all the rest. Be sure and hold that at least a core in Bitcoin, because it has that first mover advantage.
Definitely switch in when it's a little bit cheaper. I still think, like you said, that correction's coming. It can either play out, which is just think it can play out in two ways. So with these Bitcoin futures, the price can obviously reach maybe 15,000 and stabilize, because we do have institutional money coming into the market. And they are able to manipulate price like they did with silver and everything else. So we'll have, institutional capital, and that could even create two separate markets for Bitcoin. Obviously the Bitcoin that you can trade on a crypto exchange, and then there's obviously the Bitcoin that is traded.
If you take a look at BitMEX, I don't know if you have an account, you can have premiums of hundreds of dollars over or below on BitMEX. And that's your, of course, if you're not familiar, that's your futures exchange.
Different and I'm like Polyonic, but I know which one you're talking about.
You're actually thinking of 15,000 already on Bitcoin. That's pretty exciting stuff, but we do appreciate it.
Thank you for having us on the radio. We really do appreciate it.
GoldSeek employees may or may not own shares. Nothing contained herein should be construed as investment advice.
With stocks hitting new highs, the next sector to fly could be the precious metals. GoldSeek's top industry analyst just uncovered another solid gold opportunity, Silvercorp Metals. Silvercorp's key property is located in China, the largest gold producer in the world. Silvercorp's net income is soaring, up 589%. Production eclipsed guidance by 27.5%, totaling 6.5 million ounces. Mining operations are literally printing silver at only $3.82 per ounce. AISC net byproducts credits for the fiscal year 2017. Sales increased 51% year over year, and cash flow from operations more than doubled to $80 million. Silvercorp continues to set the industry standard with reduced costs, equity appreciation, a solid dividend, and improved free cash flow. Silvercorp is uniquely positioned to capitalize on rising silver, lead, and zinc prices. To learn more about the exceptional opportunity in Silvercorp Inc., direct your web browser to silvercorpmetals.com, ticker symbol SVM in the U.S. and Canada. Remember to treat your portfolio with a core position in Silvercorp Metals.
GoldSeek employees may or may not own shares. Nothing contained herein should be construed as investment advice.